Hello everyone, today I am going to the opening of the Backstage Bistro in Old Town. Let's see what happens. Backstage Bistro had been bought over by the Satrapi and will be open shortly. Poster, attend the grand opening of the Backstage Bistro. The Backstage Bistro is opening on the 13th of Ice Rain, 1348. Join us for festivities including a lottery and a drinking contest. The thing is, although Ida is a mixologist, she is a teetotaler. She doesn't like to drink. Maybe I slip in by the back entrance. A dress just dropped? Who the heck is this? Oh, this is the trope of Renatus and trope. Host, but I'm not sure what to host. Been fine so far. Jahandar is still missing. I really don't know where he went to this time. He was so excited about this bistro. It was about 8 ice rain, or in January. Not this way. Seriously, it's strange. Where did Jahandar go to? Found him already? You see us over there. Well, let's just hope Jahandar will show up, but from the way Vera's going about it, will he really show up? Hope so. Here I'm wearing vodka. Nivellen wearing a jacket, skirt, and black shirt. That's her nice clothes. wait a minute. The job of the Renitus and Chop Business Company should be Maple Chop and not Adjustress, unless Maple was a nickname. I can't see that. Weird. Let's look at this Terra Marin vodka. Filtered with imported black sand from Terra Mar. This is from Terra Mar, the land of brutality and ice. Regardless of surf temperature, it feels cold to you. Every drink from this engorges you with raging confidence. He's cracking jokes about Jekyll's hood. I think he won't take it off because he doesn't want to show his face. He feels kind of awkward about everything. Mot is a very short, spindly sort. With a shield! Oh, it's walking around with a shield now. I don't know why they say you couldn't walk through that tunnel. It's just... Alright. There's a lot of food for Carl Grimmer to experiment with. Let me see, I think you'll put Lucian Silvercrest appeared. Awkward. Oh no, not in front of him, put. But... Okay, I think we are good to go drink wise. Smells like feet. There's some games and music and things. Glasses and plates and all that. This is called Grimmer's cooking box. Paper? The only paper I got is a newspaper. Those two are playing odds and evens. I shared with Carl Grimmer's player a joke about the nasty buffet, and I think he's taken me at my word to make a seriously nasty dish. What's Lucien doing around here? And did he quit the parish or is he hiding? Whatever it is, Vera is still on rather tense terms. I wonder if Valentine will show up. Although Ida does not get sloshed, she can work. I guess Adrastus is played by someone else, it just happens to be a fellow family member of the Drop clan. Anyway, Ida wouldn't know him. She doesn't know either Drop. Thank you. called Grima, which is very heavily dressed. Let's see. He's interrupting the dancing. I wonder if Jacob and company will be Jacob and Chuck will be annoyed. Cook that with pepper so hot, you might want to see a doctor afterwards. Some people are chili fans, you know. Well, I guess the spice dish is taking a toll on those guys. Not yet, it's toast mainly. Water on rocks. Yeah, no mistaken, on rocks means on ice. Change the water. I'm going to. Okay. Here is literal water. Water on rocks as you requested. Well, hopefully it's the right item. Those sticky keyboard. I mean, maybe you should get a mechanical keyboard. They don't stick. The chilies for you, I made it very special for opening. Rare ingredients in the photo. Yeah. It's... it's very potent. There must be some unique pepper. And you are? Pleased to meet you too. Okay, now I know who this guy is, at least his first name, Adrastus. What the heck is New Balance saying? Okay. Why is Chico looking through a spyglass around here then? Chico and the Pale? Another call work? Let's see. Pale side of the moon. What you see before you make it certain death. It is a water pail full of moonshine. You can smell the strength of the alcohol as you look at it. There is no real flavor consistent with the best of moonshine. Well, let's just say they are really trying the drink. Strong as heck. Real strong stuff. It's pretty damn strong. The bistro's unlocked now. Why did Jacob yell so loud about Slayton?
Huh?
A rather old man, looks quite derisive and likely in the use of a cane or walking stick. He's back in Sancho and years of servitude, he see. A very, very old man, yep. Abinisi is talking to Weilin about his travels around the world. There's quite a number of conversations round and round and round. But that's a bar for you. It's full of conversations and gets all mixed up with each other. Things like that. Seems Avinisi was on an archaeological expedition. But I better eat some real life chili while waiting. Opening night is a little quiet, but not everyone is going to go up to a dive bar. At least Cole Grimmer. At least I didn't party a Cole Grimmer food. The instant noodle I got would be quite hot. About as hot as he made it. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Bjornar does not cook that. He's making fun of me. Oh, no, no, no. I misread it. No, it is masterfully crafted chili, of which is rarely seen even by the great Bjornar. The ingredients there required are quite heavy. Okay. I understand now. He's not making fun of me. He's not making fun of my other character. He's talking about how uncommon the recipe is. Well, the thing is, the setting of this game, smoking is heavily encouraged, but my character does not like the smell, so I guess she better politely wipe her cover her nose and not complain about everyone smoking like chimneys. It's not my container, I can't store things here. How come? Speaking collision again. What? But at least Ida isn't the only character who does not speak collation. There is another member who doesn't speak collation at the moment. Ancora Plantation. Oh, this is history specific to Moat. The plantation thing was a series of incidents in the previous act where the players of Requiem were in refuge. I do not know very much more than that because none of my characters have ever been in the previous iteration. I've only ever played Act 6. I guess Abby is sick of almonds after all that. although almonds are not very filling by themselves. You had to cook them first. Almond soup, almond bread, almonds on almonds, almond cakes. Like literally nothing but almonds. But for a month, it was almonds all day, every day. I remember why it's so quiet in game now, because people aren't weirdly walking round and round. Giant carrots for the giant rats. No wait, why would my character know anything about the Lost Island? Where were you? And Cora. That's a real long way off. I think Ancora is the place where the very, very early parts of Requiem took place. You're a very hardy person. Anselm, yeah, the same Anselm that we see in the Imwella crypt and all that. The giant shield too. Mert, I think Mert really likes walking around with a giant shield. And her purplish hair. Cole's got a sort of thing of making wisecracks about cooking. Well, I think it's kind of odd Jahandar's not here right now. Like, dude, where are you? I don't know very much about hairstyling, but I think pitch black would be really difficult. Oh, I see. Adrastus is a priest, not a businessman. Apologies, my camera malfunctioned for a little bit there. I got a community participation reward too. Because Adrastus is done with the blessing as well. It's a small, cozy opening too. Well, at least my webcam add-on will not be glitching so badly, even though I'm not sure why exactly it's doing that right now. Quite a cozy turnout. Oh yeah, it's the blessing time. We have to pray in our own way somehow. Still praying. Thank you. Well, let's hope it doesn't catch fire or very well get hit by Lucien over a gigantic misunderstanding or that sort of thing. I should thank Vera after she finished speaking. Today's a bit of Libra love. It has failed to open twice before this, said Vera. But today, 13 the ice rain.
Yeah!
Yeah, because we finally opened the bar officially. Friday the 13th, the exact opposite. A day that people shouldn't be doing things on, but we choose today. Maybe the sheer irony will make it into a lucky bar. Hey, how'd you get on the counter? What is Jiko talking about? Now I don't really understand it. Oh dear. I guess it was a staff helping issue to sticker on the bar. So Moat volunteered. Yeah, very short name to carve. Cole's custom vodka is quite potent. Since I am a Tino teller, I'm not taking part in drinking that. I will not. Is Amelia trying to drink too? Wait, Amelia wants a drink on the pail too. Like we are birds or ostriches from the Kiki's French birds. I mean, Drusilla, drink like that? Well, she's gonna get credits. She's gonna get some credits on the bar. Moat didn't like it. Drusilla had no reaction to it. And she can stomach it. Yeah. Not just Constantine's failures in a bucket, is it? His leftover brew? No, I'm pretty sure it's something else. Is Amelia alright? I mean, is Drusilla alright? Drinking like that? I wonder how much is my drink meter. Okay, I'm fairly hungry and thirsty. I probably should take something from the menu, but I am not going to drink that thing. Me drink, but I'm a teetotaler, so what am I supposed to eat anyway? Are we going to drink the rest of that? It seems Avi is backing out. does that mean? Are we sneak a drink as a little kid? Bar counter, opening night pair of moonshine drinkers, Mort, Jacob, Slayton, Drusilla, and Vera. I'm honestly still surprised, where the heck is Jacob? I mean Jahandar. Turnout's pretty good considering everything. Drusilla is drunk. Chico fell down. Well, let's hope the bar will stay open longer. Oh wait, the door is locked. Better shut it behind me so that call is not interrupted. Boat is very, very quick and short. tea. I'm not sure how to actually do that. Opening night was a resounding success for the bistro. Hopefully it will stay that way. And I'll see you next time.